that it is an imitation of the seed, the Lord of all for our sake, made light out of us, and offered himself as an offering to his Father, and ever slain, sanctifying them that partake, casting them out away from the presence, and taking out the Holy Spirit from me. May I be enlightened in body and soul, O Master, may I be enlightened, may I be saved, may I be taught thy dwelling through the communion of thy holy mysteries, having thee with the Father and the Spirit living in me, a benefactor plenteous and interceding. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. May thy body and thy most precious blood of my Savior be unto me as fire and as light, consuming the substance of sin, and burning the thorns of passions, and enlightening all of me to worship thy divinity, both now and ever unto ages of ages. Amen. God said, flesh of thy pure blood, refer all generations to him thee, O Lady, and thrones of heaven times glorify thee. His three thee they have clearly seen him who ruleth all things and due to human nature. It is truly meet to bless thee, the Theotokos, O ever blessed and most blameless and mother of our God, more honorable than the cherubim, and beyond compare, more glorious than the seraphim, who without corruption gave us birth to God the Word, the very Theotokos gave you be magnified. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, but now and ever, and to the ages of ages, amen. Most Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, cleanse us from our sins. O Master, pardon our transgressions. O Holy One, come and visit and heal our enemies for the name's sake. Thy goodness, thy transgressions, thy commandments, and not obeying thy injunctions. But thou, O Lord, who art not mindful of my suffering and plenteous of mercy, hast not given me urge to destroy all my sins, but always thou awaitest my complete conversion. And thou hast said, O Lord, mankind, through thy prophet, for I desire not the death of the sinner, but that you should return and live. For thou desirest not a master to destroy the work of thy hands, and thou shalt thou be pleased with the destruction of man, but desirest thou what we say and come to a knowledge of the truth. For even I, although I'm ready to come and earth, this temple of life, having submitted my whole self to sin, and made myself a slave with pleasure, and having defaced my image, yet being thy work and creation, wretched though I be, I will spare not of my salvation, dare to approach thy immeasurable loving kindness. Except then you and me, O Lord, lover of mankind, and thou didst accept the sinful woman, the thief, the publican, and the prodigal, and take away from the burden of my sins. Thou takest away the sin of the world after those the infirmities of mankind, to call us the weary and heavy laden unto thyself, and give us some rest. If you would stop and hold for ages, let some history happen, and you know all comes to tomorrow, to fire and flesh and spirit. Beseech me to achieve holiness and purity, and let the spirit just bring me my conscience, and receive the portion of thy holy things. I may be united unto thy holy body and blood, and have living and abiding in you, Father and the Holy Spirit, the day of the Lord Jesus Christ, my God, but not in you with thine immaculate and life ministry, the end of the confession, not grant to infirmity of soul and body, because of my petition of unworthily, but grant me on some of the last directly, without condemnation, worship of heavenly things, unto the communion with the Holy Spirit, and the provision to life eternal.
Thank you. time of this pandemic for protection and deliverance from the coronavirus. For health and recovery of those suffering through this virus and for the guidance of physicians and those who minister to you fully, good, let us pray to the Lord. For this city, for every city and country, and for the faithful dwelling in them, let us pray to the Lord. Pray to the Lord. nos и партис, и си ти дося на лапе, моменту патрике твоего, и твоего патрике, а ини, Христусе, о нас, твое одно.
Ascended in glory, O Christ our God. strength.
Wisdom.
The croaking tone 4. You are blessed, O Lord, God of our forefathers, and praised and glorified is thy name forever.
Wisdom.
Reading the Acts of St. Apostle.
Wisdom.
In those days, Paul had decided to sail past Ephesus so that he might not have to spend time in Asia. For he was hastening to be in Jerusalem, if possible, on the day of Pentecost. And from Miletus, he sent to Ephesus and called him to the elders of the church. And when he came in, he had said to them, "You yourselves know how I lived among all of you the first time from the first day that I had set foot in Asia. Take heed to yourselves and to the flock, in which the Holy Spirit has made you guardians, to feed the church of the Lord, which he has obtained with his own blood. I know that after my departure, fierce wolves will come in among you, not sparing the flock, and from among yourselves will rise men speaking perverse things, to draw away the disciples after them. Therefore, be alert, remembering that for 3 years I did not cease night nor day to admonish everyone with fear. And now I commend you to God and to the words of his grace, which is able to build you up and to give you the inheritance among all those who are sanctified. I coveted no one's silver or gold or apparel. You yourselves know that these hands ministered to my necessities and to those who were with me. In all things I have shown you that by so toiling one must help the weak, remembering the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said, 'It is more blessed to give than to receive.' And when he spoke thus, he knelt down and prayed with all of them."
Received them and have known as a fact that I come forth from you
They did believe that you did send me. I pray for them, not for the world do I pray, but for those whom you have given me. Because they are yours, and all things that are mine are yours, and yours are mine. And I'm glorified in them. And I'm no longer in the world, but these are in the world, and I'm coming to you. Holy Father, keep in your name those you have given me, that they may be one even as we are. While I was with them in the world, I kept them in your name. Those you have given me, I guarded, and not one of them perished except the son of perdition, in order that the scriptures might be fulfilled. But now I'm coming to you, and these things I speak in the world, in order they may have my job made full in themselves.
Glory to the Lord,
in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, today is the Sunday of the Holy Fathers of the First Ecumenical Council. Today is the Sunday before Pentecost, which is next Sunday, but right after the Christ Ascension that we just buried on Thursday last week, we're learning a little bit more of the Holy Fathers of the First Ecumenical Councils, who are defending the truth that was revealed to the Church not by man or human flesh, but the living God Himself. And this revealed truth in the Church, we call it dogma, because the world confuses the word dogma with the narrative of the standards of the world today. So they think it's some sort of a law, some sort of an oppressive definition to put people in a frame, to put people in the prisons, within the prisons of their minds, and to somehow make them slaves of their own destinies. But the word dogma, in the Church sense, means revealed truth from God to the human race, to the human kind. So in a nutshell, in the year 325, the middle of the 4th century, beginning of the 4th century, sent King and Emperor Constantine the Great, he summoned this great ecumenical council, where right after the persecution of the Christians within the first 3 centuries, he was able to call all of them, 318 of them at that time, representatives of their own dioceses around the Roman Empire, and discuss the most important issues that the Church had at that time. That is the time when the Bible, the New Testament, as we know it today, came in this form. That is the time when many, many issues, canons, laws, organizational and calendar issues were being discussed so that the Church will live in peace and prosperity and be unified, as we heard in today's gospel, as one with God. Because the Church, brothers and sisters, it's not an institutional mechanism, but it is the body, the mystical body of Christ, the St. Maximus of Confessor confesses. So in a nutshell, they got together, but the real reason was that this man, this presbyter, clergy, priest from Alexandria, from Egypt, his name was Arius, a very eloquent and educated man, who started spreading the theology contrary to the truth, revealed to the fathers, revealed in the Church, that Christ was not the Son of God. He was not equal to the Father. He was born and created after the Father.
So everything that we read in today's gospel, where Christ himself confesses that he is omoousios, that he is in one essence, with one essence with the Father, is actually false. And but because of his blasphemous mouth and blasphemous words, the Father of the Church invited him to repentance and to change his view, because every human being, if he rationalizes his own faith, will fall into the temptation to wrongly interpret the dogmas, the truths of our faith. Of course, he did not repent it, and he was forever excommunicated from the Church, and he became a symbol of the pan-heresies that we experience today, because the spirit of Arius did not cease to exist. Look at the division that we experience in the world. Look at the unrest among people about various issues. Look at the anxiety, how people are very easy and quick to raise their hands against each other in the name of certain ideas, ideologies. That's all, my brothers and sisters, the heresies that the Church experienced many, many years ago. Nothing. Because the prince of this world, he feeds from the fear, from the anxiety, from the mistrust, from the lack of love and hopelessness of the people. And actually, that is his paradise. So today's Gospels, brothers and sisters, was one of the most scandalous Gospels that we can read. If you heard carefully, I'll remind you again, but you can also, when you go home, read open the today's Gospels, John chapter 17, where it's being exposed and explained the Christ hierarchical prayer to his Father, our Father, where he says something very, very interesting, very, very scandalous that people don't pay attention to. And here is the following. One point he says, I would like the ones that you gave me, he's talking about the apostles, the future church, as we're going to see being born next Sunday with Pentecost, to know that you and I are one. And he says the following, and I don't pray to you for the whole world. I only pray for the ones that you gave me. And who is that? Those are the apostles, that is the Church. Christ knows that God never imposed his will to the humankind. We know that we all have the freedom to choose to even go against God. That is the sense and the real meaning of our burden of our freedom. But at the same time, we have an option. And that is the Church, which is the mystical body of God, Christ, to be the anchor upon which can put our salvation and put our lives on. So, there are many, many heresies in the world. There are many, many religions. There are many, many ideologies. They are very attractive, very rational, very interesting to maybe even follow. But there is only one truth. We can argue as much as we like about our feelings. What do we think about this? What do we think about that? But feelings don't matter when it comes to truth. There is only one truth, and that is Christ. He exposes that to us very openly. So let me ask you one question. Post yourself this one question. Is our faith, the Orthodox Christian faith, rational faith? No. But look at what we believe in. We believe that God, the Son of God, a deity, incarnated, became a human being, was born of a virgin, lived a miraculous life, healed so many, resurrected death, He dies on the cross, being a king and being a very respected prophet. And then he resurrects 3 days later. And then after 40 days, he ascends into heaven. And then the Holy Spirit being sent by his Father to us 50 days later after his resurrection, so that this church will be established. So when the first people who saw this strange phenomenon of the church being born, they said, this is nonsense. All of the governors of that time, they said, these are crazy people, those so-called Christians, the believers of the crucified one in Nazareth. So what they did, they were just observing when this new phenomenon, this new sect would fall down. So what happened was, this very educated rabbi, Gamaliel, who later became himself Christian, he said, you can read this in the book of Acts, by the way, when he says, brothers, if these so-called followers of Christ, the Christians, are not from God, their so-called miraculous gathering in church will be dispelled and disbanded in the matter of months, maybe a few years, like many, many others before. But if it's from God, then no matter what we do, no matter much how we persecute the Christians, no matter what we try to impose on them, it will only grow. And what is the result today, 2,000 years later? Everybody almost in the world knows about Christ. That is the biggest proof, brothers and sisters, that the Orthodox Church holds the unity of the faith undefiled. But the devil never sleeps. He will never stop his rage against the true church, trying to attack her in various ways. One of the most genius ways that he uses to do it is through people like Arius, Nestorius, and many, many other heretics in the church, who have attacked the church from within. They themselves were being the clergy of the church. They served in the altar of God. But then the church rejected them like an unnecessary food that needs to be evicted from the divine organism of the church. So if we see our faith from the lenses of the world, you will see that you, brothers and sisters, I myself included, first among you, are the most craziest people in the world. And that is okay, because to be a Christian in the world means to be crazy. Crazy for Christ, for something that we believe that we don't see, but we firmly understand. We know that the moment we close our biological eyes in this world, our life has just begun. And that the Pascha, the Passover, the experience of the moment of our death, is the most magnificent moment of our existence. Just a few weeks ago, when we were singing Christ is risen from the dead, that is the essence of our faith, ultimate craziness. Because the world will never understand why we still believe that Christ rose from the dead. Why do you still fool yourself with the stories from the Bible business? I want to be fooled. It's a matter of choice. As you make the choices every day to do this, that, to be evil, to do bad things, good things, I make the choice to be with Christ. And I don't care what you think about that. I never impose my own will to you. So I want you to impose your will to me. You see, brothers and sisters, God is not a tyrant. It is the demon who is a tyrant. He imposes everything upon people to accept things that they don't want, don't need. But in God, we have freedom. And the true freedom is love our God the Father through His Son, the God-man, Son of God, Jesus Christ, within the Holy Spirit, always, now, ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen.
Let us say with all our soul and with our all mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Almighty, the God of all fathers, we pray to you. Hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great goodness, we pray to you. Hear us and have mercy.
Nevertheless, do not deceive the Lord,
Spirit be with all you.
ever existing and eternally the same, Thou and Thine only begotten Son and Thy Holy Spirit, Thou it was who didst raise us from non-existence into being, and when we had fallen away, did raise us up again, and do not cease to do all things until Thou hast brought us up to heaven, and have endowed us with the kingdom which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto Thee and to Thine only begotten Son and to Thy Holy Spirit, for all things of which we know and of which we know not, for the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto Thee also for this ministry which Thou hast vouchsafed to receive from our hands, even though there stand beside Thee thousands of angels and 10,000 of angels, cherubim and seraphim, 16 many eyes, only Lord, one there is. Singing the triumphant hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
Holy, 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 Lord of heaven alone, heaven and earth are full of Thy
disciples and apostles say, Take ye, this is my body, which is broken for you, for the forgiveness of sins. Drink all of this. This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. The ascension into heaven, the seating in the right hand, and the second of the Lord is coming.
Thy all, we offer unto Thee, in behalf of all, and for all.
The sick, the suffering, captives in desolation. Be mindful, Lord, of those who bear for the universe, held in the churches, and believe back on the poor and apostles, sent for that mercy. Grant us to be one mouth and one heart to glorify and praise thy honorable and majestic name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the angels of angels.
Amen.
May the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all you.
And with thy spirit.
Having remembered all the saints again and again, Jesus, pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts which have been spread forth and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Mercy.
And our God, who loveth mankind, receiving them upon his holy, most heavenly and ideal altar, for that your spiritual sweetness will send down upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Asking for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
Unto thee, commend our life, the hope, the master, the love, the maker, and beseech thee, and pray thee, and supplicate thee, one save us, and partake of the heavenly dread mysteries of the seat of the spiritual table, and the pure conscience of the forgiveness of sins and the power of transgressions, unto communion of the Holy Spirit, unto inheritance of the kingdom of heaven, unto boldness towards the death and judgment, or unto condemnation. What saith, O Master, that we boldness and without condemnation, we may dare to call upon thee, the heavenly God and Father, and to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
That is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Be unto you, O Lord.
And with thy spirit.
Let us bow our hands unto the Lord.
To thee, O Lord.
We give thanks unto thee, O King, invisible, who by the boundless power is fresh in all things, and in the multitude of thy mercies care of all things from nothing to seem to be. Do thou thyself, O Master, look down from heaven upon those who have bowed their heads unto thee, for they have not bowed unto flesh and blood, but unto thee, the fearful God. Therefore, O Master, do thou thyself, distributeth these things here, set forth unto us all for good, according to the individual need of each. Voyage with those who sail, and sweet journey with those who travel by land and by air and above the air. Heal the sick, thou who is the physician of our souls and minds. Through the grace and compassion and love of men of thine only begotten Son, in whom thou art blessed, together with thine own holy good and life, giving spirit now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Thank you so much, Jesus Christ, for God, from the holy dwelling place, and from the throne of glory, the kingdom of God, sanctify us, with God, who seal us behind the Father, give visible present in us, and once saved by the mighty hand to impart unto us the immaculate body and precious blood, and through us unto all the fruit. O man, let us attend.
Thank you.
Господня.